17.
Tak Matúš 17.
We're gonna look in the first 20 verses.
A pozrieme sa na prvých 20 veršov.
Of course we are not going to read it all at once.
A nebudeme si to čítať všetko naraz.
Let's just start with the first verse.
Ale začneme prvým veršom.
Now after 6 days Jesus took Peter, James and John, his brother, and led them up to the high mountain by themselves.
O 6 dní vzal Ježiš so sebou Petra, Jakuba a jeho brata Jána a vyviedol ich na vysoký vrch do samoty.
Before this chapter, Jesus and his disciples went through a very intense, busy period.
A pred týmto veršom Ježiš aj so svojimi učeníkmi mali veľmi intenzívnu, boli takí veľmi zaneprázdnení.
He was teaching the disciples and the multitudes at the same time.
A učil aj svojich učeníkov, aj zástupy zároveň.
And he also was confronting the Pharisees.
A taktiež konfrontoval farizeov.
So it is really understandable that Jesus needed some time off with his disciples.
A tak je naozaj pochopiteľné, že Ježiš potreboval nejaký čas so svojimi učeníkmi.
After intense service is a good idea to slow down and pray through the things that just happened.
A po takej intenzívnej dobe alebo po takom intenzívnom období je naozaj múdre spomaliť a modliť sa za to, čo sa práve udialo.
Jesus took Peter, James and John.
A Ježiš zobral Petra, Jakuba a Jána.
And these three guys were kind of in a circle of the disciples.
A títo traja muži boli takým vnútorným kruhu, boli v takom vnútornom blízkom kruhu zo všetkých tých učeníkov.
And the obvious question is, why was they in a circle?
A taká jasná otázka tu vyvstáva, že prečo vôbec existoval taký úzky kruh?
Did Jesus have a favorites?
Mal Ježiš nejakých ľudí, ktorých uprednostňoval?
And I really don't think so.
A ja si naozaj nemyslím.
We know that there is no partiality in God.
Pretože vieme, že Boh nikoho neuprednostňuje.
But we also see that these three had a bigger desire to spend time with Jesus.
Ale taktiež vidíme, že títo traja muži mali väčšiu túžbu stráviť čas s Ježišom.
They gave it all just to be with him.
Oni by dali za to všetko, aby mohli byť s Ježišom.
And Jesus choosing these three is just confirmation of their devotion to him.
A to, že si Ježiš vybral práve týchto troch, je iba takým potvrdením ich túžby.
Let's read verse 2 and 3.
A prečítame si teraz verše 2 a 3.
Now he was transfigured before them. His face shone like a sun and his clothes became as white as light. And behold, Moses and Elijah appeared to them, talking with him.
Tam sa premenil pred nimi a tvár mu žiarila sťa slnko a rúcho jeho zbelelo ako svetlo. A hľa, ukázali sa im Mojžiš a Eliáš a zhovárali sa s ním.
And as they were on a mountain,
a keď boli na tomto vrchu,
Jesus was transformed in front of them.
A Ježiš sa pred nimi premenil.
Actually, the word transfigured is the same as it's transformed.
To slovo premeniť je to isté ako ako pre premeniť.
In Slovak is the same word.
V slovenčine je to isté slovo.
I guess it's closer to the Greek language.
Asi je to bližšie k grečtine.
But anyway, Jesus was transformed in front of them.
A každopádne Ježiš sa pred nimi premenil.
And as I look into this description of this transforming when Jesus was transformed.
A keď sa pozriem na ten popis toho, keď bol Ježiš premenený.
I can't help myself to think about the same situation in Revelation 1.
Tak nemôžem si pomôcť, ale veľmi mi to pripomína tú situáciu v zjavení Jána v prvej kapitole.
Revelation 1:12-17.
A zjavenie Jána 12 až 17.
Then I turned to see the voice that spoke to me, and having turned, I saw seven golden lampstands, and in the midst of the seven lampstands, one like a son of man, clothed with garment down to the feet and girded about with a chest and a golden band. His head as hair were like a wool and white as snow, and his eyes like a flame of fire. His feet were like a fine brass and if refined in a furnace. and his voice as the sound of many waters. His head. Let me just use it. And his head in the right hand, he had the seven stars, and out of his mouth went two sharp swords. And his countenance was like a sun shining in his strength. And when I saw him, I fell down as dead.
Takže zjavenie na 1. kapitola, verše 12 až 17. Na to som sa obrátil, aby som pozoroval hlas, ktorý hovoril so mnou. A keď som sa obrátil, uzrel som 7 zlatých svietníkov a uprostred nich niekoho podobného synovi človeka, oblečeného do plášťa a opásaného zlatým pásom na prsiach. Hlavu a vlasy mal biele ako biela vlna, ako sneh, oči ako ohnivý plameň. Nohy podobné lesklému kovu rozžeravenému v peci a hlas ako hučanie mnohých vôd. V pravej ruke mal 7 hviezd a z úst mu vychádzal ostrý dvojsečný meč a tvár mal ako slnko, keď svieti v plnej sile. Keď som ho uzrel, padol som mu k nohám ako mŕtvy.
So Jesus had a different appearance even in here.
Ježiš aj tu mal iný zjav, alebo inak vypadal.
And obviously even John couldn't cope with that.
A ani Ján sa s tým nevedel úplne vysporiadať.
And the both appearances are very similar.
A tieto dve zjavenia, alebo tieto dve jeho zjavy sú veľmi podobné.
And even if this glorious transformation wouldn't be enough. If it wouldn't be enough.
A ak by nestačilo toto slávne premenenie sa?
Now we have Moses and Elijah there talking to Jesus.
Máme tam ešte aj Mojžiša a Eliáša, ktorí sa s Ježišom rozprávajú.
And actually I have no idea how the disciples knew that was Moses and Elijah.
A ja neviem, ako učeníci vedeli, že to bol Mojžiš a Eliáš.
Maybe Jesus was, what's up, Moses, Elijah?
Možno, že Ježiš ich tak pozdravil, tak ako Mojžiš a Eliáš.
And but nevertheless they knew who were they dealing with.
Ale akokoľvek vedeli, s kým tam majú dočinenia.
It's really interesting to see that Moses finally made it to the promised land.
A je zaujímavé vidieť, že Mojžiš sa nakoniec dostal do zasľúbenej zeme.
In Deuteronomy chapter 1 we see that Moses was prohibited to go into the promised land because he misrepresented God.
A v 5. knihe Mojžišovej v 1. kapitole vidíme, že Mojžišovi nebolo dovolené vstúpiť do zasľúbenej zeme, pretože nesprávne reprezentoval Boha.
And And now there's a grace when Moses is actually there in a promised land.
A v tom je taká milosť, že Mojžiš nakoniec je v zasľúbenej zemi.
Elijah was a prophet who his life was full of miracles and even yeah.
Eliáš zase bol prorok a celý jeho život bol plný zázrakov.
And his life was like really action filled.
Je to jeho život je ako taký akčný film.
And even then Elijah was taken to heaven by the Lord.
Eliáš bol vzatý pánom do neba.
And we see that Jesus is actually fulfillment of the law and the prophets.
A my vidíme, že Ježiš je naplnením ako zákona, tak aj prorokov.
Mark 5:70 says, "Do not think that I came to destroy the law and the prophets. I did not come to destroy it, but to fulfill it."
V Markovej 5. kapitole 17. verši Ježiš hovorí: nemyslíte si, že som prišiel zrušiť zákony a prorokov, ale prišiel som ich naplniť.
And we see that the Peter we'll see later on that Peter wanted to preserve this moment.
A neskôr uvidíme, že Peter chcel zachovať tento moment. Trvala tá chvíľa.
He had Elijah and Moses and Jesus there.
Mal tam Eliáša, Mojžíša, Ježíša.
But it was actually unnecessary because Jesus was there.
Ale nebolo to nevyhnutné, pretože Ježíš tam bol.
Because Jesus fulfills law and the prophets.
Pretože Ježíš naplňa aj zákon, aj prorokov.
The law was given that it was show us that it's impossible to keep.
Zákon nám bol daný kvôli tomu, aby nám ukázal, že je nemožné, aby ho človek dodržoval.
And show us the great need for Jesus, for a savior.
aby nám zákon ukázal tú obrovskú potrebu po Ježišovi ako po spasiteľovi.
In Matthew 22 we see that Jesus summoned the whole law and prophets into two verses.
A v Matúšovi 22. kapitole vidíme, ako Ježíš zhrňuje celý zákon a prorokov do dvoch veršov.
That you shall love your God with all your heart, your soul and your mind.
Že máš milovať Boha, Hospodina svojho Boha, celým svojim srdcom, silou a dušou.
And also you shall love your neighbor as yourself.
A taktiež máš milovať svojho blížneho ako samého seba.
And Jesus is the one who really did love us perfectly and loved God perfectly.
A Ježiš je práve ten, ktorý nás miloval dokonale a Boha miloval dokonale.
He died for us, so he showed his love, his unconditional love towards us.
A on za nás zomrel, aby nám preukázal svoju bezpodmienečnú lásku.
And here we don't see that what were they talking about?
Tu v Matúšovi nevidíme, o čom sa tí traja rozprávali.
But in Luke 9:30 we see that they were talking, so he spoke about his disease, that he, what was about to accomplish in Jerusalem.
Ale v Lukášovi vidíme, že sa v tom istom zázname, že sa tam rozprávali o jeho vstupe do Jeruzalema.
So Jesus needed some encouragement.
A Ježiš potreboval nejaké povzbudenie.
It was not easy for Jesus to go to Jerusalem knowing what's going to happen with him.
A pre Ježiša nebolo jednoduché ísť do Jeruzalema s tým, že vedel, čo sa mu stane.
You see, he was God's savior, but he was also 100% human.
On bol Boh, alebo je Boh a spasiteľ, ale taktiež bol 100% človek.
And sometimes I just think about and just overlook that this fact.
A niekedy prehliadam túto skutočnosť.
Yeah, Jesus died for me, he is God, he is a savior, Messiah.
Áno, Ježiš za mňa zomrel, je Boh, je spasiteľ, je Mesiáš.
But actually Jesus knew the Isaiah 53.
Ale Ježiš poznal Izaiáša 53. kapitolu.
And even in the garden of Gethsemane he was praying that if there would be any other way.
A aj v Getsemanskej záhrade sa modlil, že ak je nejaký spôsob, ktorým by sa to dalo vyhnúť.
So here Moses and Elijah are just encouraging Jesus.
Tak Mojžiš a Eliáš pozbudzujú Ježiša.
Verse 4 and 5.
A verše 4 a 5.
Then Peter answered and said to him, Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you wish, let us make three tabernacles, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. While he was still speaking, behold, a bright cloud overshadowed them, and suddenly a voice came out from the cloud, saying, This is my beloved son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear him.
Peter prehovoril k Ježišovi, Pane, dobre nám tu je. Ak chceš, urobím tu tri stánky, jeden tebe, jeden Mojžišovi, jeden Eliášovi. Keď on ešte hovoril, aj hľa, jasný oblak ich zastrel a z oblaku ozval sa hlas. Toto je môj milovaný syn, ktorom sa mi zalúbilo. Jeho poslúchajte.
And we see that Peter is a bit confused by this.
A vidíme, že Peter je trošku zmetený tým, čo sa tam deje.
Some people when they're out of the death, when they don't have any control on the situation.
A mnohí ľudia, keď sú trošku mimo, nevedia, čo sa deje okolo nich.
So they tend to talk nonsense.
Majú tendenciu hovoriť nezmysly.
Those are people like me who speak first and later on think.
A takým človekom som aj ja, že najskôr hovorím, až potom premýšľam.
So I get in a lot of trouble.
Tak za kvôli tomu dostanem do veľa problémov.
Same as Peter did.
A tak to bolo aj s Petrom.
But here's a great lesson for us.
Ale to je pre nás skvelá lekcia.
That we should hear Jesus.
Že máme počúvať Ježiša.
You know, do I put myself in a situation when I let him speak to me?
Som v situácii, alebo dovolím, aby som bol v situácii, kedy jemu dovolím, aby mi niečo hovoril?
Do I let him speak to me?
Dovolujem mu, aby ku mne prehováral?
Okay, let's read from 6 to 11.
A teraz si prečítajme 6 až 11.
And when disciples heard it, they fell on their faces and were greatly afraid. But Jesus came and touched them and said, "Arise and do not be afraid." When they had lifted their eyes up, they saw no one but Jesus only. Now as they came down from the mountain, Jesus commanded them, saying, "Tell the vision to no one until Son of Man is risen from the dead." And his disciples asked him, saying, "Why then do scribes say that Elijah must come first?" Jesus answered them and said, "Indeed, Elijah is coming first and will restore all things. But I say to you that Elijah has come already, and they did not know him, but did to them whatever they wished. Likewise, Son of Man is also about to suffer in their hands." And then the disciples understood that he was speaking to them about the John the Baptist. So Jesus told his disciples to not speak about this yet.
A Ježiš povedal svojim učeníkom, aby o tomto ešte nehovorili.
Because his time hasn't come yet.
Pretože jeho čas ešte neprišiel.
But there will be time in the Gospels when we see that his hour has come.
Ale v evanjeliách potom príde čas, kedy on povie, že moja hodina prišla.
You can see that in John 12.
A to môžeme vidieť v Jánovi 12. kapitole.
And the scribes and the Pharisees knew before the Messiah comes, Elijah must come first.
A zákonníci aj farizeovia vedeli, že predtým, než príde Mesiáš, má prísť Eliáš.
That is from Malachi 4:5.
A to je z Malachiáša 4. kapitoly 5. verša.
Jesus told them that actually it was John the Baptist who Elijah came.
A Ježiš povedal, že tým Eliášom bol Ján Krstiteľ.
But the Pharisees didn't connect the dot on that.
Ale farizei si tieto dve bodky nespojili.
And also Jesus told them that the Messiah will have to suffer under their hands.
A potom Ježiš ešte hovoril, že Mesiáš musí trpieť ich alebo pod ich rukami.
And for them it was unimaginable that the Messiah would come and would have to suffer.
A pre nich to bolo nemysliteľné, že by Mesiáš prišiel a musel by trpieť.
They were expecting a Messiah who would conquer the Roman government.
Pretože oni očakávali Mesiáša, ktorý by porazil rímsku nadvládu.
And he would set the Jewish nation free again.
A vyslobodil by židovský národ, aby boli zase slobodní.
But the Messiah came for the bigger purposes than the political expectations.
Ale Mesiáš prišiel kvôli väčším zámerom než nejakým politickým očakávaniam.
Messiah came to save world from the sin.
Mesiáš prišiel kvôli tomu, aby zachránil svet od hriechu.
In Genesis 22:18 we have the Abrahamic blessing.
A v prvej knihe Mojžišovej 22. kapitole v 18. verši máme také abrahámovské požehnanie.
In your seed all the nations of the earth shall be blessed because you have obeyed my voice.
V tvojom potomstve budú požehnané všetky národy zeme, pretože si poslúchol môj hlas.
Because of Abraham, now we can be blessed.
A kvôli Abrahamovi, teraz aj my môžeme byť požehnaní.
And it is because Jesus became the Lamb of God.
A je to kvôli tomu, že Ježíš sa stal baránkom Božím.
As John said it in 1:29.
Tak ako to hovorí Ján 1:29.
Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world.
Hľa baránok Boží, ktorý sníma hriech sveta.
Let's see the 14th and 16th verse in Matthew 17.
A teraz znovu sa vráťme do Matúša 17. kapitoly a verše 14 až 17.
Mm-hmm. 16.
16, 14 a 16.
And when they had come down to the multitude, men came to him, kneeling down to him and saying, "Lord, have mercy on my son, for he is epileptic and suffers severely, for he often falls in the fire and often into the water. But I brought him to your disciples, but they were unable to cure him."
Keď prišli k zástupu, pristúpil k nemu jeden človek, padol pred ním na kolena a povedal, "Pane, zmiluj sa nad mojím synom. Je chorý na pádúcnicu a zle je s ním, lebo často padá do ohňa a často do vody. Priviedol som ho k tvojim učeníkom a nemohli ho uzdraviť."
So as soon they came down from the mountains of experience, problem was waiting down for them.
ako náhle sa vrátili z tohto zážitku, ktorý bol taký vrcholový zážitok na tej hore, prišli dole a čakal ich problém.
And this shows us the reality of a spiritual warfare.
A toto nám ukazuje realitu duchovného boja.
Whenever we are on a spiritual mountaintop,
kedykoľvek sme tak na vrchole, na nejakej výšine duchovnej,
we need to stay vigilant and not let our spiritual defenses down.
A musíme zostať v strehu a nemôžeme dovoliť, aby sme nejak zvalili alebo porušili tie naše duchovné obrany.
There was a desperate dad who came to Jesus for help.
Bol tu zúfalý otec, ktorý prišiel za Ježišom a prosil ho o pomoc.
Me as dad, I so many times cry out to Jesus for help.
Ja ako otec veľmi často volám k Ježišovi o pomoc.
And we all find ourselves in situations that are much difficult than our abilities to deal with them.
A všetci sa nachádzame v rôznych situáciách, ktoré sú o mnoho ťažšie než naše schopnosti na to, aby sme tie veci vyriešili.
And it is a really good idea to come to Jesus because he has mercy on us.
A je veľmi dobrá, je veľmi dobrý nápad prísť za Ježišom, pretože on s nami má sľutovanie.
The disciples could not cure this person.
A učeníci nemohli vyliečiť tohto chlapca.
You know, disciples seen Jesus to heal people so many times.
A učeníci videli, ako Ježiš lieči ľudí tak veľakrát.
And now when they were disconnected from Jesus, they thought that they can do it as well.
A teraz, keď boli oddelení od Ježiša, tak si mysleli, že aj oni to dokážu sami.
And I see a very good lesson for myself and maybe for you as well.
A v tomto vidím pre seba veľmi dobrú lekciu a možno, že sa v tom nájdete aj vy.
If Jesus is not in it, I will fail.
Ak Ježiš v tom nie je, tak zlyhám.
Again, let me say it again. If Jesus is not in it, I will fail.
A znovu to poviem. Ak Ježiš v tom nie je, tak ja zlyhám.
Jesus put it this way.
Ježiš to povedal takto.
I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing.
Ja som vinič a vy ste ratolesti. Kto zostáva vo mne, nesie mnoho ovocia. A bez mňa nemôžete nič činiť.
You know, I can go through this life and leave Jesus out.
Ja môžem prechádzať svojim životom a môžem Ježiša vynechať.
I even can do this Christianity by my own.
A dokonca aj ku kresťanstvu môžem prísť sám.
You know, Jesus saved me, now I can do it.
A Ježiš ma zachránil a teraz už to dokážem sám.
I add some rules here, I add some rule there.
Tuto si pridám nejaké pravidlá, tu si dám ďalšie pravidlo.
And eventually I will get myself in a big trouble.
A nakoniec sa dostanem do veľkého problému.
Okay, let's read from verse 17 to 21.
A poďme si prečítať verše 17 až 21.
Then Jesus answered and said, O faithless and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I bear with you? Bring him here to me. And Jesus rebuked the demon, and he came out of him. And the child was cured from that very hour. Then the disciples came to Jesus privately and said, Why couldn't we cast him out? Jesus said to them, Because of your unbelief. For surely I say to you, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, Move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you. However, this kind of does not go out except by prayer and fasting.
Ježiš odpovedal, O neveriace a prevrátené pokolenie, dokedy ešte budem s vami, dokedy vás budem trpieť? Prineste ho sem. I pohrozil Ježiš démonovi a ten vyšiel z neho. A ozdravel chlapec tú hodinu. Tu pristúpili k Ježišovi jeho učeníci a spýtali sa ho o samote. Prečo sme ho my nemohli vyhnať? Odpovedal im, pre svoju malú vieru. Veru, hovorím vám, keby ste mali vieru ako horčičné zrno a povedali by ste tomuto vrchu, prejdi odtiaľto tam, prejde. Nič vám nebude nemožné. Tento rod démonov nevychádza ináč, len s modlitbou a pôstom.
And I do believe that Jesus is not really harsh on his disciples.
Ja naozaj verím tomu, že Ježiš nebol taký drsný voči svojim učeníkom.
He is not even putting them down.
A on ich ani neponižuje.
And actually I can imagine Jesus actually smiling when he was saying that.
A ja vlastne si aj tak predstavujem, že Ježiš sa možno na nich aj usmieval, ako im toto hovoril.
Because he knows what we are like.
Pretože on vie, aký sme.
Then we see also that he is the one who is rebuking the demons.
A taktiež sa si všimnite to, že on je ten, ktorý karha toho démona.
So many times we try to go and rebuke demons.
A tak veľakrát my sa snažíme a karhať démonov.
But I don't think so that's our place to do.
Ale nemyslím si, že to je naše miesto, že to máme robiť my.
Even the archangel Michael said the Lord rebuke you.
A dokonca aj archaniel Michal povedal, nech ťa pán pokarha.
Anyway, Jesus is the one who is dealing with this situation.
Akokoľvek, Ježiš je ten, ktorý túto situáciu rieši.
He is the one who has ability to do something about our situations.
Lebo on je ten, ktorý má nejakú, ktorý má tej schopnosti niečo urobiť s našou situáciou.
And he is the one who can heal.
On je ten, ktorý môže uzdraviť.
You know, he is God and I'm not.
On je Boh a ja ním nie som.
And for him all things are possible.
A pre neho sú všetky veci možné.
And it's so good for me to rely on this kind of God.
A je pre mňa tak dobré spoľahnúť sa na takéhoto Boha.
Who has ability to heal?
Ktorý má schopnosť liečiť.
Who has ability to change impossible situations?
Ktorý má schopnosti meniť nemožné situácie.
And I can see God who is alive.
A ja vidím Boha, ktorý je živý.
We also see that Jesus saved the day.
A taktiež vidíme, že Ježiš to celé zachránil.
That he got out his disciples from the embarrassing situation.
Že on spôsoboval to, že svojich učeníkov tak vyťahoval z rôznych situácií, pomáhal im.
And I am not be able sometimes to deal with situations like this.
A ja nie vždy som schopný riešiť takúto podobnú situáciu.
But I know someone who is ready to save.
Ale ja poznám niekoho, kto je pripravený na to, aby zachraňoval.
You know, I don't have ability to do things for the people.
Ja nemám schopnosť niečo urobiť pre ľudí.
But I can point them to someone who is able.
Ale ja ich môžem nasmerovať na niekoho, kto schopný je.
And the last point.
A posledný bod.
That even faith is a gift.
Aj viera je dar.
You know, if you feel condemned by this story or your own inability of faith.
Ak sa cítite taký odsúdený, keď premýšľate nad týmto príbehom, alebo vám to pripomenulo nejaký váš vlastný príbeh.
You know, when you don't have enough faith or you don't fast enough.
Že nemáte dostatok viery, alebo že sa dostatočne nepostíte.
You know, you're in a good company.
Tak ste v dobrej spoločnosti.
You know, you can look at the disciples.
Môžete sa pozrieť na učeníkov.
You know, they walked with Jesus, they seen Jesus heal people.
Oni kráčali s Ježišom a videli, ako Ježiš uzdravuje ľudí.
And even they couldn't do the work sometimes what Jesus had for them.
A dokonca ani oni nemohli vždycky vykonať tie skutky, ktoré pre nich Ježiš pripravil.
You know, how can I in the 21st century compare my faith with them?
A ako môžem ja v 21. storočí porovnávať svoju vieru s ich vierou?
But even if healing is not your thing.
Ale ak aj uzdravovanie nie je niečo, čo robíte.
You know, lack of faith is still a problem.
A nedostatok viery je stále problém.
You know, Hebrews 11:1 says that without faith it is impossible to please God.
A Židom 11:25 spomína, že je nemožné, bez viery nie je možné páčiť sa Bohu.
But there is hope.
Ale je tu nádej.
Because we get by someone else's perfect record.
A pretože my máme dokonalý záznam niekoho iného.
You know, Jesus is the perfect one.
Pretože Ježiš je ten dokonalý.
He is the one who is always ready to do the miracles.
On je ten, ktorý je vždycky pripravený robiť zázraky.
And when I fail, I can rely on him.
A keď ja zlyhám, tak na neho sa môžem spoľahnúť.
And there is grace in that.
A v tom je milosť.
Because it will ultimately be about him.
pretože nakoniec je to o ňom.
I am freed from expectations.
A ja som slobodný od očakávaní.
And I'm free to look to him and go to him for the solutions.
A som slobodný, som voľný a môžem ísť za ním a hľadať odpovede a riešenia u neho.
So my encouragement this morning.
Takže moje pozbudenie dnes ráno.
Now whatever situation you and I are,
v akejkoľvek situácii sa nachádzame,
we always can turn to Jesus.
Tak vždycky sa môžeme otočiť, obrátiť na Ježiša.
We always can ask him to save us.
Vždycky ho môžeme prosiť za to, aby nás zachránil.
I always can rely on him to save the day.
A vždycky sa na neho môžem spoľahnúť, že because, on zachráni ten deň.
Because he is God.
Pretože on je Boh.
And he has ability to do any change needed.
A on má schopnosť, aby urobil akúkoľvek zmenu, ktorá je potrebná.
That also will create dependency to him.
A to taktiež vytvorí našu závislosť na ňom.
No longer I will have to be able to rely on myself, but I can rely on Jesus.
Už viac nebudem musieť spoliehať sám na seba, ale môžem sa spoliehať na Ježiša.
You know, so let's pray.
A tak poďme sa modliť.
And then guys will lead us into worship.
A potom chváli nás ešte budú viesť vo chváli.